my name is Annabelle Bailey. I'm from Covington, Louisiana. An interesting fact about myself is that I'm actually a dual citizen, American and British. My first monologue will be from Pollywog by John P. McKinney, and my second monologue will be from William Shakespeare's Henry VI, Part 1. You are ruining my life! You don't even know how to work the DVR! Or the iPod dock. You still read the newspapers and you wear sweater vests. You have angina. You are such an embarrassment. You are ruining my life. You are too old to have another baby. People are gonna think that I'm the mother. They're gonna think that I broke my promise ring and had sex and delivered a secret baby that I conceived with Randy Sanderson at the boat landing at the Welcome Arms after curfew, which we never did. Even though Ashley Ringer thought it'd be so Christian to stand up at share time and challenge my purity. I would never defile my chastity vow, especially not with Randy Sanderson, who doesn't even have underarm hair. We were just talking about Jesus, and about the scriptures, and about how gross his bunkmate Lance was. Randy needed to get away from his cabin. Lance smells like warm feet. He says it's a glandular condition, but we don't think so. Randy and I were just talking, and it was nice. And all those jerks like Ashley Ringer had to go and turn it into something sinful and immoral. And now, what are they gonna think? They're gonna think exactly what they already think. God, did you even consider for a second how this baby would affect me? You and Dad are so selfish. People talk, especially people from Lakeside Christian. First, let me tell you whom you have condemned. Not me, begotten of a shepherd swain, but issued from the progeny of kings. Virtuous and holy, chosen from above by inspiration of celestial grace to work exceeding miracles on earth. I never had to do with wicked spirits. But you, that are polluted with your lusts, stained by the guiltless blood of innocence, corrupt and tainted by a thousand vices, because you want the grace that others have, you judge it straight a thing impossible to compass wonders but by help of devils, though misconceived. Joan of Arc hath been a virgin from her tender infancy, chaste and immaculate in very thought, whose maiden blood thus rigorously effused will cry for vengeance at the gates of heaven. Will nothing turn your unrelenting hearts? Then lead me hence with whom I leave my curse. May never glorious sun reflect his beams upon the country where you make abode, but darkness and the gloomy shade of death environ you till mischief and despair drives you to break your necks or hang yourselves.